originally from Ghana, West Africa, living here in Atlanta, Georgia. I'm a filmmaker, screenwriter, editor, and today we're here at the premiere of my first film, The Last October 7th. It's a dark drama about the HIV virus, and I just basically wanted to make my first film have a positive message and a positive meaning, and not just be your average shoot 'em up love story, but just have a movie that could probably impact a lot of lives. Well, since I'm from Africa, HIV AIDS is a big thing in Africa. It's killing a lot of people, and unlike those in America, many people don't have the opportunity to get, you know, medication and, you know, treatment. So I felt that if I made this movie, not only would it help people back home in Africa by bringing awareness, but also would help people here in America too. So basically that's my mission right now with this film, of course. So hopefully that should shed some light on the issue. The Last October 7th is about four friends. The main character, Jesse Flynn, is an author, and he's just found that he has the HIV virus and he is contemplating suicide. But right before that, he wants to celebrate his birthday with his three friends. These three friends represent a gay man, a womanizer, and a thug. And basically, I had Jesse Flynn be the one with the HIV virus, just basically have people know that anyone can have this disease. And so the movie also talks about friendship, and there's some other twists in the movie. But throughout the movie, halfway through the movie, there's a twist of events where the main focus is off Jesse Flynn, but on his other three friends. And hopefully I could actually share a good message with this movie. Atlanta's starting to boom up in the filmmaking business. They're getting incentives now for most of the movies, independent movies they make here. And I kind of felt that, you know, since everyone is in LA and New York, you can kind of start in Atlanta and then hopefully it'll take off and you wouldn't be like just this little fish in the pond. So, and I love Atlanta. It's like, it's beautiful. So growing up as a kid, I've been addicted to films. Like I tell most of my friends, my father doesn't, he never used to buy us toys or books or anything like that. He would just buy us, he would just make recordings of movies on Betamax tapes and we'd have to watch it all day long. So I was forced to become addicted to filmmaking. So I started watching, you know, Steve McQueen, Kirk Douglas, Burt Lancaster, you know, Charles Bronson at a young age. And so I figured I knew how storytelling was, you know, how you can actually come together and make a movie work. What's a good plot, you know, how the character should be portrayed and where the climax should be and, you know, and basically where you'd be going with the whole storyline. I have three other scripts right now. The last one's not really done yet, but those I would need a lot of, I need funds to actually produce those movies. With this movie, we shot this movie with less than $1,000 budget. And, you know, we had actors who gave a lot of their time and effort to just bring in the story to life. I had my friend, Sonny Adu, who I grew up with. He's the director of photography and the editor of the movie. He flies in from Delaware with his own equipment. And they've been very helpful, but I'm not sure I can keep on living off a $1,000 budget, you know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to like move up to the next level. So those scripts are much, will have a much bigger budget. Where I come from, people don't come to America to become filmmakers. They come here to be lawyers and doctors and politicians and go back. So wanting to be a filmmaker was new to a lot of Africans and they all had to just keep on dampening my spirit, telling me that I couldn't make it work. So the 2-3 years was me going through relationships and friendships and, you know, losing girlfriends and friends over the whole process, but I stayed focused because I knew that I had something and I saw the vision. So basically that's what made it last that long. And I couldn't come up with the ending. It took me about a year and a half to just come up with the ending for the movie. So that's another reason why it took me so long. Just a two-man crew. We had our lights, we had our boom mic. If I'm not in the shot, I'd hold the boom mic. You know, he operated the camera and edited. So it was just a two-man crew. And we got it done. We carried all the equipment ourselves. It was just a two-man crew. And our cast was a pretty small cast, about 15 actors and actresses. Well, it's kind of cliche, but it's the same old thing, like, do not give up. Like, if you really feel it in your gut that you can bring a story to life, because for me it's a beautiful experience. I'm actually seeing my movie come from a piece of paper to an actual film, and that for me is a great, you know, accomplishment. So I'm telling everyone out there, like, if you really feel that you have that passion and if you really love to write, see it through. Because there's a famous movie director called Jon Favreau. He once said, before he did the movie Swingers, he said that, you know, just don't write the script because it might never get picked up, no matter how good it is. find people who are willing to bring it to life, you know, find a cast, find a crew, find people who want to just basically help you bring your story to life, and you can see it through. I believe that. I'm a living witness too, so yeah. I want to also go ahead and thank a lot of people who helped me make this possible. I want to thank my cast, you know, they were remarkable. They were basically, only one of them, Charlotte Haz, is a professional actress. The rest of them were just everyday people, and they actually read the script, became one with the character, and they nailed it. Actually everyone nailed it. I also like to thank my director of photography and my editor, Sonny Adam. He put his job on the line and came all the way down to Atlanta to help me make this movie become a reality, and he's been remarkable. And I'd like to thank my wife, because it's been hard for her, you know, having to see me go out late and make shoot scenes and everything and still be understanding. So I'd like to thank all these people who helped bring this to life.
My name is Sony Adu, originally from Ghana. I live in Delaware. I'm a videographer, editor, director of photography, and I helped John shoot his movie, TL07. I'm kind of like John. I grew up watching a lot of movies. I always watched movies with my mother. I'm actually into a lot of animation also. I'm an anime junkie, but you know, I've always been into, you know, movie making and into music videos, into music a lot also, so you know. And I've always been artistic, so I felt like I could do what I saw on TV, you know, so I started, you know, learning on my own actually, and so far it's okay so far. Hopefully it'll take me places. Anything to, you know, inspire people, you know, anything to for a good cause, you know. I felt like it was a good cause, and it might bring some more, like some awareness, you know. But yeah, that was it. I'm always looking to do something that'll help others.